Harry Brook here, Ag Fieldman for Flagstaff County. And I'd like to talk today about weeds. What is a weed? Well, really, a weed is just a plant that's out of place, right? In a place it shouldn't be. And today I'm going to talk about this example, which is from a yard site that's crept into the road allowance here. And it's maybe Shasta daisy, maybe it's oxeye daisy, but the problem is it's an invasive weed. It's spreading. It doesn't stay where you put it. And as such, this would be considered, if it's oxeye daisy, we consider it to be a noxious weed. Therefore, it has to be controlled. Now, this area sprayed last year, but there's a lot of seed in the ground. And we have a lot of dead grass here because it's not grazed, because it's on a road allowance. So that tends to open up the canopy. The difference between a Shasta daisy and an oxeye daisy, they're almost indistinguishable. The fact is, if it's moving out and it's being invasive, then it becomes a weed. And this area needs to be sprayed. What would be considered noxious weed, it's always changing because it depends as you get new plants come in that expand. For example, one of the problem weeds that occurs in gardens and in the black soil zone is chickweed. It was originally brought in as ground cover for gardens. Only did the job too well, plus the fact it produces extensive seed and is now considered a field crop weed as well as a garden weed because it's just so difficult to control it all. So this area needs to be controlled. But always be aware of what's in your garden, and if you start seeing it creeping out, then it's entered the realm of being a weed. It's in places where it doesn't belong. So be vigilant. Look for plants that look out of place, even if they're pretty. Yellow clematis is considered a nice garden flower. Some people grow it, but it's also on the noxious weed list, which means it should be controlled, especially if it gets outside the garden. The province has a Weed Act, which lists prohibitive noxious weeds, which are weeds that are hopefully not present in the province, but if they are, they must be eradicated immediately. And then there's another list of weeds, which is the noxious weeds. Now, one of the worst weeds in the county of Flagstaff is scentless chamomile. And we are sitting in a field that looks like they've put it in the hay last year, but they've not dealt with a scentless chamomile. We see, if you have a look at these plants, they have hundreds, literally hundreds of seed heads. If this is not treated, it's going to pollute this soil and put enough seeds into the seed bank that it's going to be a continual problem for at least the next 10 years. Now, what we do in our county is we first approach the landowner and say this has to be controlled by such and such a date. There's a lot of urgency to get this controlled because it's starting to flower. We don't want these seed heads to mature and produce mature viable seed. Therefore, we give them a chance to control it. If that doesn't work, then we wish you a weed notice. Now, weed notice under the Weed Act requires them to control it by such and such a date. Now, control, you can discuss what that is. It could be something as simple as mowing and baling and burning or spraying with a herbicide, but it's got to be controlled. If they do not follow the deadlines on the weed notice, then the county has the right to go in, get it controlled by that date, and the cost of the control is put on the taxes. There's no way around it. Either control it yourself or we'll do it. But it's important that we get this under control. All weed problems usually start from one plant. But if you look around here, down along here, there's a ton of these scentless chamomile. They're spread throughout this whole field. So this is a problem that they've got to control right away. This is not something to just shilly-shally with. So, if he doesn't get it controlled very quickly, it's weed notice time, and if that doesn't work, we'll control it for him, and he pays for it.